It's interesting though seeing the gentlemen ushers from the city chambers wearing fancy hats. Never seen them wear fancy she's over there. Yes, yes. Yeah, because it's a bit grander than the one in Dunbar. It's on its last legs. Yep. it looks like the deputy provost is doing things rather than the provost. Somebody's written for her. Turn your you're on mute, dear. She's on mute. Thank you.
As long as it's well before the football. Like 10 o'clock or something. It's a midday kickoff. Yes. Or even earlier. Right. 10 o'clock will be fine, right, bye.
Tell you that your regiment is part of today. day's order of battle, and if well deployed, give its war fighting role as light cavalry in the event that the army is called upon to fight. Nobody should be in any doubt about the purpose of your regiment or the British Army. Nothing about what is happening in Ukraine will emphatically underline why it is important that we have committed, motivated, trained servicemen and women who are prepared and ready to fight for you, the good people of this city and for our country. For this reason, in recognition of the events I've just mentioned, your agreement, your regiment has adopted a different appearance today, and in so doing, I trust, sends a clear message of purpose to you, to all those gathered here, and of solidarity to our friends elsewhere fighting for their cities and their country. In recognition of our solemn obligation to the city of Edinburgh, ever vigilant we will be. Deputy Lord Provost, it remains for me to thank you, your staff, for hosting us today, and to the good people of this city for the honour of awarding us, your regiment, Scottish and North Irish Yeomanry, the freedom of the city of Edinburgh. Thank you.
Slow! Arms!